Residential treatment is a 24-hour mental health invitation in a highly supervised and structured group living setting where individualized and related therapies are provided. This type of service is helpful for those with mental illness by having the availabilities, the professionals, and the security it needs in order to keep those with mental illness safe and secure.
This type of treatment is specialized for severe cases that cannot be treated in any other way. This is not a hospital for those with broken legs or sickness. This is for those with mental issues and strives as best as it can to get the help to those who really need it. Although these residential facilities have many of the resources they need, many of those with mental illnesses wind up in the worst places for them to be, prison. Considering the behavior of the mentally ill can result in confusion or illegal actions. Many of them are sent to prison instead of residential facilities where they can get the help they truly need.
Prisons do not have the number of mental health beds that they do patients. So many mentally ill are placed in standard settings. Prison conditions for people with mental health problems are quantifiably different than those with people without mental problems. For example, inmates with mental illness are twice as likely to be injured in fights as compared to those without mental illness. Due to this, many of those with mental health issues in prison end up being beat and neglected by those without mental health issues. There are not the correct steps for those with mental illness and does nothing to provide help to them.
Residential facilities remove the mentally unstable from the general population, reducing the risk of potentially criminal actions. Instead of putting them in prison where they will not receive the help they need, it is wise to place those with mental illnesses in a residential facility. If the goal is to take danger off the streets and keep the community safe, would it not be wise to place those with mental illness where they can go to get help to be fit for the community? If so, then the prison system is not the place for them to go.
The residential program has been successful. Inmates using it were significantly more mentally stable when they left. Their infraction records were greatly reduced afterwards. This reduced management costs for the prison. So taking those with mentally illnesses out of the prison is not detriment to the prison or taxpayers, but actually helps. It even reduces the cost for the prison. This benefit leads to putting fundings elsewhere, places where the prison could actually benefit from it.
These residential facilities sound like an aid on the mental health community, but are they feasible? This question is hard to answer. Although residential facilities have already had an impact on those with mental health issues, it does not dismiss the cost of attending these residential facilities. It is hard to pay for services that are provided at residential facilities. They have to pay professionals to attend to people 24 hours a day and pay for beds along with it. Because of this, residential facilities may seem unfeasible to those who would have to pay more than desired.
Helping to cure and prepare someone with a mental illness is not cheap nor easy, and it is up to those willing to address the issue if it is feasible for them or not. Nonetheless, this process takes time and money to achieve the ultimate goal of helping and hopefully curing those in need of medical attention.
Although this process can be expensive, there are alternate ways of paying for the treatment other than paying penny out of pocket. Government Medicare and so-called Medigap insurance plans can help pay for certain residential facilities, but unfortunately do not apply for all of them. Considering how much these facilities can cost, any amount of help is a good amount.
The cost of residential treatment can place itself out of reach for those who don't have insurance policy or something similar to Medigap. Nonetheless, this program uses that money to provide skilled workers, proper beds and services, and professionals who will be worth the cost.
Residential facilities do come at a cost, in a literal sense, but the overall effect of the aid provided by these residential facilities is worth it. Those with mental illness will receive training and highly skilled professionals to ensure help is given. Facilities like these also give those with mental illness a better alternative than prison, being homeless, or worse, in a community that may not understand them or how serious their mental state is.
Although it may seem hard to uphold and manage a residential facility, the overall effect is priceless. Those with mental illness benefit greatly from these facilities, and because of this, they become better suited for the outside world, and this gives back to the communities. It does not take from them.
The problem of getting help to the mentally ill is growing worse. Funding for programs and services has been cut by $4.35 billion for 41 states. The money cannot go to a place where it won't be used to its full potential. There is none to waste on poorly constructed programs or facilities. Although funding is short, I believe that it should go where getting aid is easier and more available for the mentally ill. Community mental health facilities are close to the community and those who are mentally ill. Without requiring those with mental illness to leave the comfort of their homes or their community, these healthcare facilities provide care and attention to those who need it. Community healthcare facilities are nearby, hence the name community, and so it excels in bringing the help to those who need it. These community facilities or centers also offer more comforting access to care, thus gaining the approval and trust of those in the community. Some people with mental illnesses, be them afraid to admit it or deny there being a problem, may find it difficult to seek out and leave their friends and family to go to a residential facility far out of their comfort zone. These community centers help counteract that denial and fear by providing help close by and increasing the effectiveness of getting people the help they need and much faster. Many have heard of the ACT, and no, not the test, but it is known as assertive community treatment. Some key features of the ACT that increase its effectiveness are the delivery of comprehensive services to individuals, immediate communities and homes, individualized treatment plans, access to service 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and services provided by a collaborative team of multidisciplinary experts. These centers are not merely facilities, but they are willing to step out of their way to ensure treatment for the patient in a comfortable, relaxing way. Truly effective for those with mental illness who cannot travel to a residential facility or are not sick by hospital term. Although this plan sounds effective so far, is it feasible? The general answer is yes. It requires not just those in charge of the centers, but also the community's help. These centers run on employees and trained professionals, and at times, the centers need those in the community to provide these two very important tools. At the core of the ACT's model's community-based philosophy is participation of members of the community in the governance of the program and the deliveries of services. Not only do these community centers provide help for the mentally ill, but also bring jobs to the community, which has been a long-occurring problem on its own. Some may see this as too much of an effort on the community's part to help provide for the mentally ill in these centers, but it doesn't end with distributing pills to the mentally ill and providing a few complicated jobs, but some centers are willing to train the mentally ill to be prepared to face the world once again in a new way. One can call this plan impossible, unfeasible, but the center known as the Fountain House does such a thing. The Fountain House offers trainings to those who attend in the workforce. Anytime during the weekday, the patients or members, as they are called at the Fountain House, can tend to the garden at the facility, participate in writing articles in their newspaper, and even make plans on how to manage diabetes. For those with doubts about the scale of this program and how practical it is, the Fountain House serves some 350 people a day and up to 1,500 visits each month. ICCD has helped the model expand to 326 clubhouses in 29 countries, serving 50,000 people a day, with 220 clubhouses in the United States. It may take time and effort on the people's part, but overall this plan is not only feasible, but gives back to the community in ways of job and training, something most communities have been left without for a long time. It is pointless to try and sugarcoat the issue of cost. It's expensive. If $4.35 trillion was cut alone from the mental health care program, it is easy to imagine how much the mental health care centers need to function. But this cost has been reduced and chipped away over the years. The desire to save money and cut taxes has seen people with mental health problems abandon, to fend for themselves on the streets. So the cost for these centers would be great considering how little budget they have been left with. This may be considered discouraging or frightening, but it requires money to give those in need the help they require. Those who can apply for jobs at these community centers, however, will be putting money back into the community. Once they receive their payment and spend it in their community, it will cycle through the system, and at a slow but sure rate, the community centers can help repay for the money they require to start off. Community centers provide help to those in the comfort of their own area, Although funding is short and the funding required is great, the overall benefit is worth it. These centers can provide jobs and aid and help bring money to the communities by paying the employees who live in the community. It's not a risky investment, but a permanent and helpful one.
Where would funding go to have the greatest impact?